In this video, I'm gonna show you how to play Gran Turismo 6 on PC. This is an updated version of the original tutorial video I made last year, and it includes extra information that was missing and also the new updates for RPCS3 in 2024. Without wasting any time, let's get started. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below. And here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have rpcs3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer, and then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you want to go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Now, on the folder where you installed the emulator, I'm gonna go ahead and create two folders right here. One called update and the other one called DLC, because I'm also going to be showing you how to install the DLC for Gran Turismo 6 on the emulator. This is optional. You can just create whatever folder you feel like it, but in my case, I'm going to be doing like this. We're gonna need this for later. Now back on the emulator folder, there is this folder here called games that was already created when you installed the emulator. And this is the folder where you're gonna be placing the game files. And you can do this by dumping your own copy of the game or finding it online. But this is something that I can't show here on the video or even mention it because it's against YouTube's policy. Now with all the files in your possession, open the emulator and click here on file and then install packages and REPs. I have both files right here, like I said, the PKG and the RAP file. So you can just select both of them like this and click on open. Probably going to take a little longer before it finishes because this is a big game too. So just wait until it is finished. There it is, installation successful and the game is showing up right here. But you're gonna notice that this is still the vanilla version of Gran Turismo 6, right? We don't have the updates yet. So we're gonna do that right now. We're gonna be using this tool right here to get the updates. This little software called Rusty PSN. This tool basically allows us to get updates from any PlayStation 3 games without having to go through a Discord server or create an account or anything like that, right? This one, we just need this tool right here. We're gonna copy the serial of the game and get the updates. But let's start by downloading the tool itself. So click here on releases. Right now, the latest version is this one, 036. So just download this, extract it, and then execute the file. So this is what the software looks like right here. Very simple. And the first thing you want to do is click here on the gear and change the download path for the updates to that one updates folder we created on the RPCS3 folder. If you did it like I did, the folder is right there. So select the download path for that one. And now, for downloading the updates, we're gonna need the title serial of Gran Turismo 6, and we can get that on the emulator. So let's go back to it right here. So this is the game, right click on it, and on the option from the bottom, copying info, you're gonna click on copy serial right here. Now go back to Rusty PSN right here and just paste the code and click on search for updates. And like this, it's gonna list you all the updates available for Gran Turismo 6. However, for Gran Turismo 6, we are not going to download every update available. And that is because if you install the updates from the package version 1.06 and beyond, the emulator is gonna suffer severe graphical issues and very bad frame rate. So for getting the best performance of this game on the emulator, we are only going to download the versions 1.02 all the way to 1.05. So do this one in your side here as well. I'm just gonna click then right here, manually like this, and there you go. That is all you're gonna need for Gran Turismo 6. There you go, the download has finished. So now let's go back to the emulator and click here on file. And then once again on the option install packages, now we're going to select the updates folder right here. In my case, it has the serial of the game. And then we're just gonna install all of these updates. Click on open, it's going to ask you if you want to install multiple packages, say yes, and then click install. And now let's install the DLC. In my case, I downloaded the Velocity Pack for Gran Turismo 6, just to give it as an example. So click again on Install Packages, go back to the root folder of the emulator. Right here it says DLC, and I have here the PKG and the RAP files, like I said. So select both of them, click on Open, and there you go. Just as quick as that, it has installed the DLC as well. Now we're going to tweak the emulator settings for Gran Turismo 6, which is the most important part of this tutorial, of course, so that we can get the best performance out of this game. The first thing you have to do is here on the emulator, you're gonna click here once on this config, this window will show up, and then you just close it down. And now close the emulator and go back to the emulator folder. And right here, double click on this folder called GU configs. And then double click on this setting right here, currentsettings.ini. You should be able to open this with the default notepad from Windows because this is a simple text file. So just double click it and look right here on the bottom for the meta section right here. So this option that says show debug tab equals false, you're going to change this one from false to true like this. That way we have enabled the debug tab on the emulator that is required for this tutorial. So click here on file and then save. Now you can reopen the emulator like this, and right here on the game, click on it with the right button, and right here it should be something like create custom configuration. It's because I changed it before, but anyway, it is the same option. So just click here on the CPU tab, you're gonna change the SPU block size from safe to mega. Now click here on GPU. On the GPU tab, the only option you have to make sure that is enabled is anti-aliasing right here. You need to set this one to auto, otherwise you're gonna have some weird graphical glitches on the game. And also make sure that the render is set to Vulkan as well. And you could change the default resolution as well, because this game does support 1080p. But in my case, I'm going to leave mine on the default 720p. Now on the Advanced tab, enable this option here, Accurate RSX Reservation Access. And where it says RXX FIFO accuracy here, change from fast to atomic. And finally, on the debug tab, enable these two options right here, disable occlusion carries and force CPU bleed emulation. That's pretty much it. Now click on apply and then save configuration. Let's also configure the controller as well, if you haven't already. If we just go here on handlers, it will auto detect the controllers that you are likely using. In my case, I have an Xbox controller, so I'm just going to select mine as X input, and it's pretty much done. Now click and save, and just double click the game. When you open it for the first time, it will give you these loading PPU modules configuration. This shouldn't take long to complete. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC, focusing on the best graphics and performance. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.